In this Photoshop tutorial, I'm going to show you an easy way to combine photos and match the color together. All right, I'm in Photoshop 2024, and to make sure we're working on the same workspace, let's go under Windows, and we're going to choose Workspace. I'm using Essentials, and then we're going to reset Essentials. So now we have exactly the same layout. All right, let's start by opening the two images. So we're going to choose File, Open. And I have these two images here. I'm going to select them both and then click Open. Now we get both of them inside of two different tabs. Now, if you were bringing these images in from the library, you would simply open Libraries and you would just double click to open it. And to combine it, you can just simply click and drag the second image in. But in this case, we're not working that way. All right, there's a couple of ways to combine these. One of them is we can choose Window Arrange, and we can do two up. And then we can simply click and drag, hold the Shift key to center it, release, and we can drag the second image in that way. Let me show you another quicker way. I'm just going to right click and I'm going to choose Consolidate All to here. The other way to do it is to simply click, drag up into the tab. Notice the second image now opens. Don't let go yet. Hold the Shift key, release, and now we've combined both of them into one document. So whichever way you want to do that is perfectly fine. And if you're getting any value out of this video, hit that subscribe button, turn on notifications, you won't miss any of my videos. All right, so we now want to cut out the woman. So let's go over to the tools and we're going to choose the quick selection tool. And the reason we're doing that is because we want select subject to be available. Click the arrow and go down and choose cloud. This will take a little bit longer, but it's going to give us a better quality selection. And then we're going to choose select subject. Now I'll select our woman. But we also want to include some of this foreground because we're using the quick selection tool. And notice that the plus tool is there. All I need to do now is just drag to add to that selection. Now, if you go too far with the selection, you can hit the Alt or the Option key and that will take away from the selection. In fact, let's not bring this foliage in. Let's just bring in the rock. And if you want to add to the selection, release and just drag. Okay, this is pretty good, but let's check the edges of this selection. We're going to choose Select and Mask. Now just grab that opacity, just give it a wiggle, make sure the whole thing is selected. It's looking pretty good, but notice we've got kind of a dark edge around it. So what we want to do is just choose Decontaminate Colors. And then click OK. And that Decontaminate Colors will get rid of that colored fringe. Notice now that we've applied that, what it's done is it's hidden the background. Let me hit the Shift key. You can see there's our background. Now it's hidden. And we can see there's our subject against the city. All right, let's grab the Move tool. And let's reposition her. So notice we can move it around. I'm thinking somewhere in there is pretty good. Now if you've got this extra bit that sticks out, no problem. Just grab the Marquee tool. Make a selection around it. Notice it has a mask. So where that mask is black, it hides whatever's on that layer. Where it's white, it shows what's on that layer. So what I want to do is just fill that with black. If you notice the background color here is black. So if you hit Control Backspace or Command Delete on the Mac, that will fill with the background color. And now we've hidden it. Great. Next thing we need to do is we need to match the colors a little bit more with the background. Before we do, let's do light direction check. So if we look at our model, notice that the light is coming from the right side. We can tell because the shadows are on the left and the highlights are on the right. Now let's check our background. Notice the highlight areas are on the right, shadows are on the left. So this is going to match as far as the direction. Now, if that direction was the opposite, all you would need to do is just simply choose the layer, hit Control or Command T, right click, and then we would flip horizontal. And then we just put it on the other side. But in this case, we don't have to because the light direction is matching. But the color and the tone is a little bit different. So with that layer selected, what we're going to do is we're going to go under Image, Adjustments. Then we're going to go down to Match Color. Now, Match Color is an incredible tool. This enables us to match the color and tone, not just from our image, but we can do it from any layer, or we could even do it on a different layer on a different image. If you look at the top, there's a couple of tabs here. Obviously, this is the old one where she came from. But if we look under Source, notice that those match. So the one we're working on right now is the New York City Midtown. So we're going to grab that source and we're going to use the New York City Midtown, of course. So now we're working within this document. Now notice there's three layers in here. If we click, you'll see those layers are also available. So we can choose any layer now within this document. And the layer we want to match with is the background. Now there's two ways we could do this. Of course, we could change the woman to match the background, or we could change the background to match the woman. In this case, we're going to change her to match the background. So let's choose background. And there it is. Notice when I do, immediately it takes on the tonality and color. Now, obviously, it's a little too much. So what we do is take fade. And then we're going to take fade all the way down, and that is the original. So what I'm going to do, and this is how I always do it, I just fade it out completely. And now we just start to increment it in. Notice how it starts to change until I see a match. So what we're really looking for mostly here is a match of the hue or the color itself. Not so much the intensity of the color, but just the color cast. Then we can go up under color intensity. This is our saturation. And if I increase that, notice it becomes very saturated. If I take it all the way down, it becomes black and white. So what we're trying to do is just match the amount of saturation that matches that scene. And I feel like this is slightly desaturated. So I'm looking here at the Empire State Building, and I feel like we're starting to match quite nicely there. Okay, and the next thing is luminance, which is just the brightness. If we take it to the left, our image will become darker compared to the background. Go this way, it becomes brighter. So let me just pull the match color out of the way a little bit. And we're just looking at this, and how do we want to match this? I'm feeling like I want to go a little bit brighter because maybe she's higher up here, and in this higher altitude, she's probably catching a little more light than the shadow areas in the city would be. So I'm going to brighten that up a little bit. And I feel I'm going to drop the color intensity down a little bit and also fade it a little bit more. All right, so if we look at this before and then we look at it after, I think it's definitely matching a lot better. Let's click OK. Now, there's another thing I might want to do on here, and that's add a little bit of blur to the city because, you know, I've got a little bit of depth of field going on here. Because she is very close to the camera, so she would be nice and sharp, but that city might be a little bit more blurred because it's off in the distance a little bit. So let's grab the background, and I'm going to right-click, and I'm going to convert this to a smart object. The reason I'm doing that is because now when I apply that filter, if I want to change it later, I can. But if it's not a smart object, that's just going to be baked in, and you're not going to be able to undo it later. All right, so what we're going to do is we're going to choose Filter. Let's go down to the blur gallery, and I'm going to put in field blur. All right, and now we can adjust the amount of blur that we want here to kind of match. Maybe that blur is a little much, but we can also adjust it under here, under the field blur. So we can just take this down a little bit more. Let's go for about 4. Then click OK. All right, so now our woman is overlooking New York City. This is just a simple tutorial. Hopefully you learned a lot of good stuff in here. So hope you enjoyed this simple tutorial. Let me know in the comments if you learned anything new and you found this useful. By the way, the written steps for this tutorial will be on photoshopcafe.com along with most of the tutorials that I do. And if you're new, welcome to the cafe. Hit the subscribe button, turn on notifications, and you won't miss any of my tutorials. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.